Have you ever created a complex arbitrary waveform only to find out that despite all of your painstaking efforts to be very precise and exact, you realize that you need to make one little change and have to create a whole new arb? I'm going to show you how Trueform waveform generators can help you reuse, resort, or trigger your arb waveforms to build a whole new signal instead of starting from scratch. Let's go to the computer. I have a couple of arb waveforms that I've created to perform dropout testing on the bench. The first one I am going to open is just a normal sine wave. And once I load that into the BenchLink Waveform Builder Pro software, I can control how I want to set up my sequence. This is going to be the first arb in my sequence, and I want to go ahead and play this arbitrary waveform until a trigger is received. And then for my marker mode, I'm going to set that to be low at start, and you'll see why when I load in my next waveform, which is a faulty sine wave. What makes this a faulty sine wave for dropout test is that it has a lower amplitude than my standard trigger. Instead of manually changing the voltage settings on a standard sine wave, I'm using ARB metadata to specify the amplitude. ARB metadata also contains information for sample rate and filter settings in case you want to change those as well. For my play control this time, I am going to repeat this one smaller segment three times every time I press the trigger. And I'm going to set my marker mode to be high at start. This gives me a trigger that I can use on my oscilloscope when I'm testing multiple pieces of equipment to allow me to see exactly when my faulty signal is coming in. So let's download this to the instrument. And I'm going to set my sample rate to 10 kilosamples per second, just a nice round number. And it will automatically go down to the instrument with my settings for high level, low level, and my filtering. If I go to the waveform generator, I can see that I've got it set up. I'm going to press the local button. And every time I press my trigger key, I'm going to get a few short cycles on the oscilloscope. So press the trigger and a few short cycles. And I can do that again so we can see that. Now if I want to make a change, I can go back over to my computer, and instead of saying repeat for three cycles, I can actually select repeat until I receive another trigger on the instrument. This basically creates a situation where every time I press the trigger key, I toggle between my normal sine wave and my dropout or my shorter amplitude sine wave. So again, I'm going to send this data down to the instrument. Here we go. And I have my normal sine wave on the oscilloscope. When I press my trigger button, I get my shorter sine wave. And when I press it again, I go back to my original waveform. So now I can control exactly when I get my dropout signal, and I can see how my device under test behaves. Now I want to do even more with my waveform. And instead of having just a dropout signal, I actually want to add some noise to my signal. I'm going to select the entire waveform cycle, and I am going to perform some waveform math under the Edit menu. I'm going to select noise as being a standard waveform with just a little bit of amplitude. I don't want it to be a big part of my signal. So I'm going to select 0.2 volts peak to peak and press OK. I get a preview of my waveform. And when I select OK, it will go ahead and add it to the entire waveform. Once I get my waveform with the noise added in, all I have to do is download the new sequence to the instrument. I can use these same techniques to reorder waveforms that I already have, change the triggering, or even add new sequences or new steps to my sequence. With the deep memory, up to 64 megasamples, you can create really complex sequences with up to 512 segments. Now that the waveform is downloaded to my instrument, I can go ahead and press my trigger key to get my noisy waveform. And when I'm ready for my clean waveform, just press my trigger key again. So it's very efficient for me to go back and forth between a noisy signal and a very clean signal on demand. Using these techniques, you can save time and memory by using Trueform waveform generators to sequence smaller waveform segments to create a whole new signal rather than starting from scratch. I hope this helps you out, and thank you for watching.